Psalm chapter 119, verses 49 to 64. Remember your word to your servant, in which you have made me hope. This is my comfort in my affliction, that your promise gives me life. The insolent utterly deride me, but I do not turn away from your law. When I think of your rules from of old, I take comfort, O Lord. Hot indignation seizes me because of the wicked, who forsake your law. Your statutes have been my songs in the house of my sojourning. I remember your name in the night, O Lord, and keep your law. This blessing has fallen to me, that I have kept your precepts. The Lord is my portion, I promise to keep your words. I entreat your favor with all my heart. Be gracious to me according to your promise. When I think on my ways, I turn my feet to your testimonies. I hasten and do not delay to keep your commandments. Though the cords of the wicked ensnare me, I do not forget your law. At midnight, I rise to praise you because of your righteous rules. I am a companion of all who fear you, of those who keep your precepts. The earth, O Lord, is full of your steadfast love. Teach me your statutes.
Yes. As followers of Jesus Christ, we are gathered to worship and confess our beliefs. We believe that the Bible, as originally written, was God-breathed, both verbally and in every part. It is the final authority of our faith and lifestyle. We believe in one God, the Creator of heaven and earth, that in the unity of the Godhead, there are three persons, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We believe that the Lord Jesus Christ, God's Son, was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of a virgin. He lived a sinless life, died and rose from the dead, ascended bodily to heaven, and is coming again to rapture his saints and establish his kingdom. We believe that the Holy Spirit is a divine person, equal with the Father and the Son and of the same nature. We believe man was created by a direct act of God and not from a previously existing form of life. By voluntary transgression, he fell from his state of innocence. Consequently, all men are now sinners by nature and by choice. We believe salvation of sinners is divinely initiated, holy of grace, and accomplished only through the mediatorial work of the Son of God. It is not of works or religion. We believe in the local church and the universal church, which is the body of Jesus Christ. We believe water baptism is the single immersion of a believer in water, in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, to show his identification with Christ in his death, burial, and resurrection. It can do nothing for his salvation. We believe that the Lord's Supper is the commemoration of his death until he comes. We believe in the bodily resurrection of the just and the unjust. Believers by faith in Christ will spend eternity in the presence of God, unbelievers in everlasting punishment. We believe that every believer should live for God and separated from the world, and by the aid of the Holy Spirit should walk in Christian love and holiness. We believe that Jesus Christ commands his church to make disciples of every nation. We believe that the greatest thing man can do for himself is to love God above all, and the greatest thing he can do for others is to show them how to love God above all.
In camp along the hills of light, ye Christian soldiers rise and press the battle ere the night shall veil the glowing sky. Against the foe and veils below, let all our strength be hurled. Fit is the victory we know that overcomes the world. Faith is the victory. Faith is the victory. Oh, glorious victory that overcomes the world. His banner over us is love, our sword the word of God. We tread the road the saints above, it shouts of triumph trod. By faith they like a whirlwind spread, swept on every field. The faith by which they conquer death is still our shining shield. Faith is the victory. Faith is the victory. Oh, glorious victory that overcomes the world. On every hand a foe we find, drawn up in dread array. Let tents of ease be left behind, and onward to the fray. Salvation's helmet on each head, with truth all girt about. The earth shall tremble neath our tread, and echo with our shout. Faith is the victory, faith is the victory. Oh, glorious victory that overcomes the world. To him that overcomes the foe, what raiment shall begin. Before the angels he shall know his name confessed in heaven. Then onward from the hill of light, our hearts with love aflame. Jesus conquering name. Faith is the victory, faith is the victory. Oh, glorious victory that overcomes the world. Faith is the victory, faith is the victory. Oh, glorious victory that overcomes the world.
Pingaga mga kauturan, kamusta ka mo? Nagpasalamat kita sa Ginoo sang oportunidad sa siningation nga makatuon naman kita sang tulong sang Ginoo. Ang kung daw anonimo kakilala ang isa ka tawo, dira man adira nagadepend ang imo pagsalig sa iya. For example, kung kilala mo ang driver, bisan daw ga bawod-bawod pa na or nagaikis-ikis, kay kilala mo siya iya, mas kampante ikaw. In fact, pwede ikaw yung makatulog, pwede ikaw lang kayo humyuhom, why? Kay kilala mo, inang a driver, sagad-sagad, he was able to drive 1,000 times sa sinangaruta. Pero, kung hindi mo siya kilala, jutay lang guro nga liko-liko, or jutay lang guro nga mulumanog-manog, nga, or ikis-ikis nga pang biyahe, daw manaog ka na kay mamangkot ka. Anong man, kabalo ni siya, basi bagulang gini siya naka-drive, basi bunggo kami. O kung wala ka na gidyas ang may mahimo, ti amo na eh, ipos ka na lang, kag gina-endure mo lang ang imo anxiety all throughout the trip. And I think that is also the same with our relationship with God. The reason why we get depressed, we get discouraged, permi kita nagka-complain sa Ginoo, or many people even leave the faith because gapatigid ako nga hindi nila kilala gid si Jesus Christ. Amoy na nga damo sa mga tao, even though they claim that they were Christians or they are Christians, gapanik sila, especially sa sininga situation. Wala sila peace, wala sila joy, wala sila love, which dapat nag-manifest sa ila kabuhi because ang Holy Spirit ara sa aton, ara sa ila kabuhi. Kag amu ina ang ginahambal naton nga fruit of the Spirit. Si Hosea, no, in his criticism, especially sa mga priests during that time, bangod nga wala nila ginaubra ang ila trabaho, and that is to teach the people about God. Siling niya sa Hosea chapter 4 verse 6, "My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Because you have rejected knowledge, I reject you from being a priest to me. And since you have forgotten the law of your God, I also will forget your children." You see, Kadelikado-delikado gigali kun sala o kun hindi ikaw kakilala kun si sino si Kristo Jesus. Because ang kabalo ka mo, anong pinaka dako nga kompromiso, dari it will cost your eternity. It will cost your eternity. So, sa sininga aga, aton pagatun-an, sinugid bala si Jesus Christ? Kag nga kinahanglan gid naton, kilalahon naton siya. Kun si sino siya. So if you have your Bibles with you, kindly open sa Matthew chapter 16, verses 13 to 17. Ang pulong sa Ginoo nagasiling, "Now when Jesus came into the district of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, 'Who do people say that the Son of Man is?' And they said, 'Some say John the Baptist, and others say Elijah, and others Jeremiah or one of the prophets.' He said to them, 'But who do you say that I am?' Simon Peter replied, 'You are the Christ, the Son of the living God.' And Jesus answered him, 'Blessed are you, Simon, Bar-Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father who is in heaven. Mag-pray kita, Anay. Dear Father, salamat gid sa sininga aga nga gintipon mo naman kami para ikaw ma-simba sa espiritu kagamaturan. Gabeg gid kami, Father, nga tagaan mo lang gid kami sang focus sa pagpamati sang imo pulong. Kagang among tagsa-tagsa katagipusoon, handa lang gid nga mag-akseptar sang gusto nimo nga amon matun-an. Kag ready man ang among tagipusoon nga magbuhat sa mga butang nga gusto mo ipabuhat sa amon. Nga pray kami sa imo balaan nga espiritu nga ikaw gid magpanghikot sa amon kabuhi. Agud nga mas ma-intindihan namon ang kabubuton sang Ginoo sa iyang pulong, kag mas mahimaya kapagid, kag mas mahimaya ang Ginoo as we listen to your word today. Speak through your servant, palihog amay, because apart from you, we are nothing, I am nothing. In Jesus' name, amen, amen. Now, last time, nagtuon kita nga may mga Pharisees kag mga Sadducees nga nagkadto kay Jesus Christ. Kag nagdemanda sila para kuno nga magpati sila that si Jesus magapakita sang sign from heaven para nga magpati gid sila. Pero ginhambal man naton dito last time nga ang pagpalapit nila kay Jesus Christ not really to believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. Wala gito sila sang intention kay katig-atiga sa ilang pusoon. But they were just looking for ways in order to accuse the Lord Jesus Christ. Naghambal si Jesus nga wala na sang sign. Iya ina sang evil kag adulterous kag generation. Kag siling niya, wala na sang ibang sign except sang sign ni Jonah. Which means, the talk si Jesus Christ nga kung may isa ka pinaka-importante nga milagro o kung sign for people to be convinced that indeed Jesus Christ is not only the Messiah or Savior of the world, pero Diyos siya, amo ina ang iyang pagkabanhaw. So after sina, naglakat sila, si Jesus warned niyang iyang mga disciples not to be contaminated, not to be leavened by the influence of the Pharisees. Kagaga, refer inisya sa doktrina sa mga Pharisees, which is sa iban nga passage sa gambaldera nga hypocrisy or batasan nila of unbelief. Because ang mga Pharisees kag mga Sadducees, they don't really want to believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. They refuse to believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. Bisan pa, sulit-sulit nga ginhambal ni Jesus sa ila kung si sino siya. Kag hindi lang gani ginhambal eh. Nagpakita pa si Jesus ang dumudamo ng mga milagro to convince people that indeed that he was the one who was sent by God, by the Father for the salvation of the world. Kag after sa to, dindala ni Jesus ang iyang mga disciples way north, na pinaka-norte dito, sa lugar nga ginatawag nga Caesarea Philippi. Kagari na kita sa chapter 16, starting verse 13. Now when Jesus came into the district of Caesarea Philippi. Again, ang Caesarea Philippi aray dire sa northern Israel, no? Kung makita nyo dira sa idalom, ara ang Galilee. Sa idalom, nabalas ang circle dira, no? Ara ang Galilee, dira na nagdako si Jesus Christ. Makita mo natin ang Nazareth, makita natin ang Capernaum. Pero gindala ni Jesus Christ dito sa babaw-babaw sa Caesarea Philippi, isa inikono ka Greco-Roman city, no? Sang dira ang area kung sa din ang tribe of Dan nagstay sang una sa dalom na sila. Galing kay wala to sila sang lugar, nagsaka to sila sa babaw. Magbasa na naton ang story dira sa Book of Judges, which is daw kalaw ay man gani nga story, no? Ang Caesarea Philippi ara na siya lapit sa Mount Hermon or almost arang it sa Mount Hermon, kagdira na da ang ginahalinan sa Jordan River. Ang Caesarea Philippi kuno mga 30 miles siguro daw papunta Bedra north of Sea of Galilee, kag medyo taas-taas ni siya, 1150 feet above sea level. So ang present day name sang Caesarea Philippi amo ni ang Banias, so part ni siya sang Syria. Kag kun lang tawon nimo diri sa Caesarea Philippi, may arad ako nung dako nga lapad nga rock, no, nga daw lapad nga kataas mga 100 feet no above sa isa ka person. Kag lapad-lapad siya mga 500 feet wide. Kag ara no nang sa tunga ya dira, may ara na dira nga daw cave, no, galing kay later na guba na kuno bangod sang I think sang earthquake, no. Kag siling niya siling sa mga archaeologists kag I think ara pa man na sa subong nag-scatter dira ang different temple ruins which was actually built by Herod the Great, no, in honor sa kay Emperor Augustus Caesar, munang temple of Augustus sang 19th century BC. Kag siling ako no dira ko na sa temple in front of the cave. No, amo na da ko no ang gateway sang underworld where the Greek god Pan lived. Ano pa nang very adulterous na no kalaway ko no sa mga ceremonies. Dira may mga sexual relationships, no. Kag pagkatapos ang laing dira nga ang mga worshippers have even sex with goats, no. Do ka grabe gid yang pagdistort, no, sang nami nga design sang Ginoo. So amo ini ang context gindalhat ko ni Jesus Christ sa sining nga place ang iya mga disciples and standing in front of this seemingly thriving religion nga amuya ang ginasimba sa mga tawo ining sipan, plus amo man ni ang area nga nagasimba ang mga tawo sa emperor sang Roman Empire. Gin pabangkot niya ang mga disciples niya. Anong pabangkot niya? Siling niya, who do people say that the Son of Man is? Siling niya, ano ang ginasiling sa mga tao parte sa anak sang tao? Again, imagine mo, no? Nga to siya, nagatindog, probably ambot ko may mga worship ceremonies sa katabo ang ginasimba nila inang Diyos Diyos. Siling niya, kamuya. Kamu. Ginapamangkot ko kamu. Kung babatian mo ang mga ginapanghambal sang tao parte sa akon, nga anak sang tao, anong ginahambal nila? Now, ang Son of Man, actually makita natin ini siya sa Daniel chapter 7 verses 9 and 10. Siling da sang pulong sang Ginoo, as I looked, thrones were placed and the Ancient of Days took his seat. Kapati ako ang Ancient of Days, gerefer ini sa God the Father. Siling niya, his clothing was white as snow, and the hair of his head like pure wool. His throne was fiery flames. Its wheels were burning fire. A stream of fire issued and came out from before him. 1,000,000 served him. Grabe, no? 1,000,000 served him. And 10,000 times 10,000 stood before him. The court sat in judgment and the books were opened. Kagahambal tayo sa Daniel chapter 7 verses 13 to 14. I saw in the night visions, and behold, with the clouds of heaven, there came one like a son of man. And he came to the Ancient of Days and was presented before him. And to him was given dominion and glory and a kingdom, and all peoples, nations, and languages should serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion, which shall not pass away, and his kingdom one that shall not be destroyed. You know, ining Son of Man, actually, amo ini ang isa sa mga favorite nga name ni Jesus Christ. Nga gina-refer niya sa iya kaugalingon mga around kuno 80 times sa New Testament. Ini nga name gina-recognize actually isang mga Hudiyo nga title sang Messiah nga who will come. Kag ang Son of Man nag-emphasize man sang pagkatawo ni Jesus Christ. No? Pagkatawo sining Son of Man. Nga muna nga wala gina-prefer sa mga Hudiyo nga i-use kay para sa ilang nga tawo. And that is, pero si Jesus Christ, ingamit niya ini to focus on his humiliation according kay John MacArthur and submission of his first coming and his work of sacrificial substitutionary atonement. And that is why si Jesus Christ, permin siya gambal, Son of Man, Son of Man, Son of Man. It's a title of the Messiah. Now, nagpamangkot siya, sino ako according to people, no, sa mga tao. No, actually, si Jesus Christ, kabalo naman siya. No, sa ginapaminsar sa mga tao. But he just wanted nga ang iya mga disciples should be aware sa perception sa mga tao kung si sino si Jesus. Why? Again, kaya hindi siya gusto nga ang huna-huna sa mga disciples will be affected by the leaven of the Pharisees. Amo na bala, atubang nila si Jesus, kita nila ang mga miracles, kabalo sila sa Old Testament, and yet, sala ang ila pagkilala kay Jesus Christ. Ukon, they intentionally refuse to acknowledge that Jesus Christ is indeed the Messiah. Siling sa mga disciples, Jesus, according to them, siling nila, Matthew chapter 16, verse 14, siling, and they said, some say, John the Baptist. Actually, ini siya, una-una ni King Herod, kakadumdum kamot sa Matthew chapter 14, verses 1 and 2. Siling, at that time, Herod the Tetrarch heard about the fame of Jesus. Kag siling, and he said to his servants, this is John the Baptist. He has been raised from the dead. That is why these miraculous powers are at work in him. Though wala man ta ka bati nga si John the Baptist nag-perform siya miracles, ang iya lang preaching, very, very powerful. Pero para kay Juan, para kay Herod Antipas, nga si John the Baptist, no, is a person of power, kagsang nabatian niya si Jesus Christ. Siling niya si John the Baptist. Muna nga gusto ganit niya nga makita si Jesus Christ. Ang iban man nga nagsiling, siling nila, siling niya, others say Elijah. No, Elijah. Why? Kaya siling diri sa Malachi chapter 4 verses 5 to 6, siling niya, behold, I will send Elijah the prophet before the great and awesome day of the Lord comes. And he will turn the hearts of the fathers to their children and the hearts of the children to their fathers, lest I come and strike the land with a decree of utter destruction. So kung makita natin dari nga siling niya, maabot si Elijah, kag ining iya message will turn the hearts of fathers to their children and the hearts of children to their fathers. Ano pa, during Passover meal, bisan asa subo, mag-celebrate na sila, magkaon sila sa Passover meal, may isa ginadara ka empty nga chair. No? Kay ina siya gina-reserve sa kay Elijah, whom they think, no, whom they are anticipating, that Elijah will come and announce the arrival of the Messiah. Ubuwit sa totoo lang gid, nakaabot na. Nakaabot na. Now, sino pagid? Diri nga Manila, hindi lang si John the Baptist, hindi lang si Elijah, kundi naghambal naman sila si Jeremiah. Dira ko sa 2 Maccabees, ang isa ka apocryphal book, no, chapter 2 verses 4 to 8. Naghambal sila nga sang gulubon sang mga Babylonians sa kabilang ang ginpang after sa kay King Josiah, no, if wicked ang mga kings sang Israel, so gintugyan na sila sa Babylonians. Inikuno si Jeremiah, siya ang nagkuha sang Ark of the Covenant, kag altar of incense. Ang Ark of the Covenant gani isan sa time na ni Jesus Christ dito sa temple ni ang ipatindog ni King Herod, ang house ng Holy of Holies, wala na to. No, actually, wala na na. Wala na na. Nadula ang Ark of the Covenant sa pag-atake sa mga Babylonians. No, kagin exile ang mga Israelites going to Babylon. Nagapati sila, it was Jeremiah who took the Ark of the Covenant and the altar of incense, kagin kintago diya kuno sa Mount Nebo, in order to preserve them from desecration and destruction. Agamoy na, nga nagapati sila, nga kung mag-abot ang Messiah to return and to establish His kingdom, si Jeremiah kuno magabalik. Magabalik siya sa earth, kag i-restore niya ang ark, no, and the altar to their proper places in the temple. So amoy na, magkilala nila si Jesus Christ, si Jeremiah. Siling man sang iban nga si Jesus Christ just one of the prophets. Although si Jesus Christ ga-refer man sa iya kung kaisa nga prophet. No? Damo sa mga tao nga gina-idolize niya si Jesus Christ, no, gina-revere na nila siya, gaka-awed sila sa kay Jesus Christ. But they do not believe that He is the Messiah. He is the Savior. Ang tawabla sa Matthew chapter 21, verses 45 to 46. When the chief priests and the Pharisees heard these parables, they perceived that He was speaking about them. And although they were seeking to arrest Him, they feared the crowd. Why? Because they held Him to be a prophet. No? So mga kontra ni Jesus, wala nila gindakop. Wala nila gindakop si Jesus because para sa ila, base kaluoy kita sa tao, maangakig ang mga tao. Kay para sa mga tao, Jesus is a prophet. Matthew chapter 16, verse 15. Padayon si Jesus, naghambal sa ila. Di niya, okay, kung amo ako siniya sa mga tao, I'm just one of being looked up nga tawo, but still tawo. Pero kamuya. Munamban niya. Matthew chapter 16, verse 15. Siling niya, but who do you say that I am? Kung akuya, kung kamuyang pamangkuton, sino ako? Pag naghambal si Pedro dayon, siling niya, you are the Christ. Ikaw ang Kristo. Ang Kristo is a Greek term sang Messiah sa Hebrew. Ang dugay na nga ginapaabot sa mga Israelites, deliverer of Israelites, the anointed one, the coming priest, coming king, coming prophet and savior. Ginhambal ini ni Peter nga wala na pang alang-alang. Ikaw gidya ang Messiah. Naging padala sa Diyos to be the Savior of the world. Unlike sa mga tao dito sa Israel during that time, gabilib lang gid sila ya, nga si Jesus Christ, nothing but advance party sang Messiah. Sang Messiah. Anong hambal nila? How? Katotabla sa John chapter 12, verse 34. So the crowd answered him, "We have heard from the law that the Christ remains forever. How can you say that the Son of Man must be lifted up? Who is this Son of Man?" Kinagambal si Jesus Christ nga. Sinabi niya, "Kung ako ma-lift up," no? He was talking about the manner kung paano siya mapatay. Sinabi niya, "I will draw all men to me." Sinabi niya, hindi ba? Ang Mesiyas, hindi niya mapatay. He will remain forever. Yan, ano niya man? Hindi sa kaya kay Chindi. No, they think of a different Messiah. And that is why they got easily offended. Dira sa John chapter 6, verse 26. Ginconfrontar sila sa after tawla ng pakaon si Jesus Christ sa ila. Sa pagi sa lima katinapay, kagduwa ka isda. Wow, gusto nilang imuon si Jesus nga hari na dayon. Isang nalagyo si Jesus, ginsunod, ginila, ginpangita. Yan, Jesus, iawang kami pangita. Sayang, Jesus, amo inihay. Sige, "Truly, truly, I say to you, you are seeking me not because you saw the signs, but because you ate your fill of the loaves." Tingnan, ipangita nyo ko, not because nga kapati ka mong ako ang Mesiyas, but nanamitan lang gig kamuya sa ginpakaon na ako. Matthew chapter 13, verses 54 to 57. On coming to his hometown, he taught them in their synagogue so that they were astonished, agsilinya, and said, "Where did this man get this wisdom and these mighty works? Is not this the carpenter's son? Is not his mother called Mary? Are not his brothers James and Joseph and Simon and Judas? And are not all his sisters with us? Where did this man get all these things?" And aring subo, they took offense at him. But Jesus said to them, "A prophet is not without honor, except in his own hometown and his own household." Kasubo, no? Hara na siya, tanan nga mga signs, tanan nga ginhambal man sa Old Testament regarding as signs for the Messiah, ara. But the people chose to blindly ignore who Jesus Christ. That is, he's the Messiah. Kag amuin na ang ginhambal ni Peter. Kag ikaduwa ang sugpon, ang part 2 sa ginhambal ni Simon Peter, silingya, "You are the Christ, the Son of the Living God. The Son of God, the Son of the Living God." Ang buot siringon sang Son of the Living God, this is actually a claim for deity. Gina-acknowledge ni Peter na si Jesus Christ, hindi lang siya yung ginpadala sa Diyos kamay. Siya mismo, Diyos. Diyos. Unlike sa palibot nila, nga dumudamo the gods during that time, na ginasimba sa mga tao, including ang emperor sang Rome. Siling nila Ginoo, hindi ka lang ang Mesiyas as far as the Israelites is concerned, kundi ikaw ang Diyos nga dapat ginasimba diri sang mga tao sa siling time. And that's why kung makita naton bala, ang mga disciples earlier, in-worship nila si Jesus. Ay, hindi lang para sa ilan nila si Jesus, Messiah, kundi Jews siya. Matthew chapter 14, verses 32 to 33. "And when they got into the boat, the wind ceased. And those in the boat worshipped him, saying, 'You, truly, you are the Son of God.'" Ikaw, Gidya. Sang pagkabanhaw ni Jesus Christ, naglakat sila, nakita ay sila dito sa Galilee. Ang hambal sang Matthew chapter 28 verse 17, "And when they saw him," and that is Jesus, "they worshiped him, Although may iba man nga nag-doubt, pero ang mga disciples, almost all of them, I believe, worship Him. Why? Because they were convinced that si Jesus Christ is not only the Messiah, the Savior, but He is God. Ano yung mga Jews? Abaw, kadumdum ka mo? Sa John chapter 5, verses 16 to 18, na may ginayo si Jesus tong paralyzed man for 38 years. Ay, papayo ang Jesus. Yan, tindog, dalang imo at imo tululugan. Ay, nangakig ang mga tao. Kay that time, it was Sabbath day siya nga, ginbitbit mo ya ang kwan. Ginbitbit, magabitbit kaya sang imo tululugan. Wala sila yan nalipay. Nga ining tao had suffered for 38 years. Mas nag-focus sila kaya sang bit-bit-bit-bit sang tululugan. Isiling sang John chapter 5 verses 16 to 18. This was why the Jews were persecuting Jesus, because He was doing these things on the Sabbath. But Jesus answered them, "My Father is working until now, and I am working." Siya tingin tatay ko ka Brahman subong. Kag ako mo Brahman eh. And this is why the Jews were seeking all the more to kill Him, because not only was He breaking the Sabbath, but He was even calling God His own Father, making Himself equal with God. Imagine mo, ang mga disciples siya, worship nila si Jesus upon clearly the clear declaration ni Jesus Christ na Son of God siya, pero ang mga Hudiyo ya preferred to kill Him. Ini mga tao, para sa ilaya si Jesus Christ ya, is just a human being. And any claim of the Lord Jesus Christ to be the Messiah, much more to be God, should be rejected. Kagsubo man sa sining mga inadlaw, amo man ina, kadamo sa mga tao, nga gambal sa si Jesus, good man na siya, good teacher, good philosopher, pero totood lang gid. Kung paminsaran mo gid, either you have to choose between Jesus Christ as God o kung si Jesus Christ liar or buang or lunatic. Kaya isa man, paano si Jesus Christ manging good man kung hindi ka magpati sa claim niya nga siya Jews, di ba? Nga siya Mesiyas. Paano nga good teacher siya? Kaya hindi ka magpati nga Jews siya kung gina-accuse mo siya nga butigod siya. So paano ang isa kabutigon manging good teacher, isa kabutigon manging good man, ang isa ka kulang sa pinsar will be a good philosopher. That is why a moment ina, ang challenge sa imo kagsapon. Do you believe na si Jesus Christ, Messiah? Probably, yeah. Pero do you also believe that Jesus Christ is God? As He claimed to be. Sabi ni mo, ining realization ni Peter, ining sabat ni Peter was actually commended by the Lord Jesus Christ. Sili niya, "Happy are you, Simon Bar Jonah." In-mention niya di ang name ni Peter before he met the Lord Jesus Christ. So nung niya, bulahan ka, amo ka lang ini sa una, si Simon ka lang sa una. Bulahan ka. He should be blessed. He should be happy because of this knowledge of the truth. To understand the Lord Jesus Christ as the Messiah, the Savior of the world, and to understand and to be convinced that He is God, that He is worth all the worship, all the honor, all the confidence, is the best realization one could ever have in this world. Kung kaintindi ka sini, kung kabalo ka sini, regardless kung damo ka pa problema, regardless kung wala ka kwarta, regardless kung damo sang diferensya na lawas mo, you need to be very, very, very happy because dira ni mo na realize nga may manluluwas ka sa imo mga sala, and there and and siyaman amo ang Diyos who is way, way, way powerful to care and secure us for all eternity. Knowing Christ for who He is the most valuable treasure one can have in this world. Nag-imagine na bala kung hindi mo kilala si Jesus Christ. Sakto? But we have to acknowledge, man, as far as God is concerned, or si Jesus Christ was concerned during that time, na hindi bangod kay smart kita. Hindi kay sagad-sagad kita mag-analyze. Hindi bangod nga, you know, kuhan lang ikuya. Mayo lang ikuya magpanilag. Because in humble ni Jesus Christ, after commending Peter, gulahan kagid nga na-intindihan mo iniha. Gulahan kagid nga na-realize mo ni. Dapat happy kagid sa ni. But in order to make him feel blessed more, silingya mo ini, flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father who is in heaven. Kung silingya bini mo, hindi ni bangod sang imo abilidad. Ang nagpa-inchindi sa imo ni, ang nagtudlo sa imo ni, ang tatay naton sa nang ang tatay ko sa langit, God Himself. Sa John chapter 1 verses 10 to 13, natawabla, He was in the world and the world was made through Him, yet the world did not know Him. Kita mo? The world did not know Him. Wala nila yung ma-realize. He came, that is Jesus Christ, He came to His own and His own people did not receive Him. Wala nila gihapon ma-realize. Cursing niya, but to all who did receive Him, who believe in His name, ari na, nagtuo sila that He is the Christ, the Son of the living God. He gave the right to become children of God. Pag anong humble ni John, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of men, but of God. Ang aton pagsulod sa panimalay sang Ginoo, hindi bangod kay dugong bughaw ka, hindi bangod kay binbirabirahan mo git, nag-effort ka git, o kon may nagpatigayon sa imo, may nagbaninoy sa imo sa langit, hindi. You became part of the family of God. Kay gusto lang git ni God for you to be part of the family of God. For us to be part of His family. Nantawa bala, Ephesians chapter 1 verses 3 to 5. Silinga dalayawon, blessed be the God and Father of the Lord Jesus Christ who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in heavenly places. We are so blessed. Ang tanan-tanan galing kinahanglan tanga spiritual blessings ara na. Why? Because He chose us in Him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and blameless before Him. Singa, in love, He predestined us for the adoption to Himself as sons through Jesus. Ay, wala iya pa matugagali ang kalibutan. Gindumdum ka na sang ginoo. Yeah, Peter. In a way, siguro, paraphrase na, Peter, hindi bangod kaya alam ka nga na-realize mo nga si Jesus, amo ang Kristo kagang Diyos siya. Wala pa yung matuga ang bilog ng kalibutan, gusto na naiyas ang amay nga makilala mo ako. Gusto na naiyas ang amay nga maintindihan mo na nga amo ako sini. Nga lang ito, blessing niya, predestined for the adoption to Himself as sons through Jesus Christ. Sugpodra, according to the purpose of His will. According to the purpose of His will. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verses 6 to 8. Yet among the mature, we do impart wisdom, although it is not a wisdom of this age or the rulers of this age who are doomed to pass away. Siling niya, but we impart a secret and hidden wisdom of God, which God decreed before the ages for our glory. None of the rulers of this age, understood this, for if they had, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. Grabe na. Kaya kahit kung naintindihan lang tani nila to, just like naintindihan sa mga apostles, sa mga disciples si Jesus Christ, hindi tani nila to pag ilansang si Jesus Christ. Siling ni Paul, siling niya, the natural person does not accept the things of the Spirit of God, for they are folly to him, and he is not able to understand them because they are spiritually discerned. Ang mga truth sang salvation, ang truth sang deity ni Christ, these are spiritually discerned. And that is why, mga utod, medyo hindi ka man sini. Nakatuo ka na gid man kay Jesus Christ, na siya man gid ang Mesiyas, siya lang gid ang makaluwas sa imo, kag at the same time man, Diyos siya. Tagapatigid ko nga ini siya actually, should go hand in hand. Kaya abi ninyo, kung si Jesus Christ be hindi Diyos, paano yabi mabayaran ang sala sa bilog ng kalibutan? Kaysa sala ko pa lang to, kagintuga lang siya bisang Ginoo, isa lang nakapangatsi sa Ginoo, mapuspuso na siya, hindi na pa mabayaran ako mga sala. Kaya nga, ang kaakig sang Ginoo sa damo-damo kong mga sala, ibubo na sa iya. Kasi kung ordinaryo ka lang ganyan nga tinuga sang Diyos, bisan anghel pa. Isa ka lang na iya kapangatsi, hindi mo na kaya. How much more pa ang kasalanan sang pilakabilyon ng mga tao nga luwason sang Diyos. And that is why the one that should pay our penalty should be God himself. Should be God himself. Amo ina nga, kinahanglan gid sa imo pagtuo kay Jesus Christ as your Savior, kinahanglan man gatuo ikaw nga Diyos siya. Of course, natuwa pala dira, no? Simbahon siya, dayawon siya, tagaan siya sa ngalan, above every name. Kung tinugala na sa iya, that's very, very blasphemous. Kulang tawon nat mo ang Bible. Kag ma-analyze mo pagid. Actually pala, si Jesus Christ hindi lang kontentong kilala ta siya nga Savior siya. Kag Ginoo siya. Kay sa John chapter 17 sa prayer bala niya sa iya mga disciples. Siling niya, when Jesus had spoken these words, he lifted up his eyes to heaven and said, Father, the hour has come. Glorify your Son, that the Son may glorify you. Since you have given him authority over all flesh, to give eternal life to all whom you have given him. And this is eternal life, that they know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. Ano ang nangin offshoot sa imo pagkilala kay Jesus Christ as Messiah at pag-acknowledge mo nga Diyos siya? Eternal life. Kag ano ang essence ng eternal life? It's still knowing God. It's still knowing the Lord Jesus Christ. Kag ang, that is why ang eternal life, hindi iya magbegin kung mapatay ka. Subong nga daan, gina-journey mo pa. Nga ang imo pagkilala, hindi lang again as Messiah si Jesus, as God, kundi every day, how He provides for our needs, how He cares for us, how He loved us, how He disciplines us, how He rewards us every time nga mag-obey kita sa iya, how He affirms us, how He comforts us kung gahibi-ibi ka, how He honors us every time nga nangin victorious kita sa aton kabuhi, how we are blessed to appreciate Him more every time we open God's Word and read, how encouraged we are every time nga mag-pray kita, every time nga mag-fellowship kita sa mga kauturan sa Ginoo. This is eternal life. day after day after day, we know who God is. We know God more. We know Jesus Christ more. And that is why, sirin niya dira sa John chapter 17, verse 20, 24 to 26, after saying that prayer for his disciples, sirin niya, I do not ask for this only, but also for those who will believe in me through their word. And that refers to us, the future Christians. Sirin niya, Father, I desire that they also, whom you have given me, may be with me where I am, to see my glory that you have given me, because you have loved me before the foundation of the world. O righteous Father, even though the world does not know you, I know you, and this know that you have sent me. I have made known to them your name, and I will continue to make it known. Grabe na. Napakilala ko na ang imong ngalan. Kag ipadayunon nakon nga ipakilala pagit. That the love in which you have loved me may be in them and I. You know, ang pagkilala sa Ginoo, it's not a one-time deal. It's eternity. Kag the more years nga ma-experience ang Ginoo, mas gaka-appreciate na siya. Mas rin kita sweeter as the years go by. Aga muna dira may isa ka person sa Bible nga even though he had a lot of things, namudamo siya sa credentials nga pwede naman makatinikal siya, pwede naman nga makapasugid-sugid siya, pwede naman nga ini mag-comfort sa iya. Pero abinimo ginsikway niya. Para lang, anong iyang exchange sinitanan ng suffering, ining sacrifices, para lang makilala niya si Jesus. Amoy na si Apostle Paul, Philippians chapter 3, verses 7 to 10, whatever gain I had, I counted as loss for the sake of Christ. Indeed, I count everything as loss because of the surpassing worth of knowing Christ Jesus my Lord. Yan ang inami, gadya. Bayida, basta ka ng inami, gadya, kung makilala ko si Kristo Jesus na akong Ginoo. For His sake, I have suffered the loss of all things and count them as rubbish in order that I may gain Christ and to be found in Him, not having a righteousness of my own that comes from the law, but that which comes through faith in Christ, the righteousness from God that depends on faith. That I may know Him and the power of His resurrection and may share His suffering, becoming like Him in His death. Ano pa, because of this desire ni Paul, not only to know Him sa una-una niya, no, sa iya nga pagtuon, but even sa iya pag-experience. He wanted to know Christ even in suffering. Kaya muna bala mga utot, sa aton subong, damo kita sa suffering. Actually, part ina man gihapon sa knowing Christ. All circumstances, kung sa diin ikaw subong, kung mang insensitive ka lang sa leading sa Ginoo, that is a way that you would know Christ better in your life. Even in tough situations. Kag ini nga desire ni Apostle Paul, abinimo ano, strengthened him and made him continue and made him faithful even till the end. Before siya napatay, nantawa pala, naghambal siya diri sa 2 Timothy chapter 1 verses 11 to 12, sulat siya sa iya disciple. So yung nga amoy ni, for which I was appointed a preacher, a gospel, a teacher, an apostle and teacher, appointed preacher of the gospel, actually, dira, no, sa verse 10, which is why I suffer as I do. Bangod sang akon nga passion sa gospel, di amo ni, nag-antos ko, singa, but I am not ashamed. For I know, grabe no, I know whom I have believed, and I am convinced that He is able to guard until that day what has been entrusted to me. Sino niya kay kilala ko ya. Kilala ko ya. Kung sino ang ako ang ginto. Kilala ko. Mga utod, kilala mo gitman si Jesus. Okay? Kilala mo siya at Savior. Jesus. Pero pamangkot, nga nagaka-anxious ka. Nga nagapanik ka. Nga dugay-dugay ikaw, nakadepress ka. Kilala ha ang Ginoo. Know Christ and you'll be fine. You'll be fine. Trust Him. Go to His Word. Obey. Learn. Learn from Him. Even sa mga sacrifices, subong, tanan-tanan nga mga problema na gina-go through nimo, kilala si Jesus Christ. And you'll be fine. And just like Apostle Paul, you will say, I know whom I have believed. And that is why, mga utod, tandaan naton ini, knowing Christ is the key to life. You know, hindi lang ini sa eternal life, ha? Kundi even subong sa temporal life. Temporal life. Nga man, kaya mo niyang hambal ni Jesus Christ. Siling niya, the thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. Pero ari ko di, ang inyong Messiah ang kilala nyo. Ari ko di, ang Ginoo ang kilala nyo. I came that they may have life and have it abundant. Ari ako diri para ikaw maka-experience sang nami-nami niya kabuhi. Sang sadya-sadya nga kabuhi. Sang nagabarangisi nga kabuhi. Despite nga may mga sakit hawak, ha? Sakit tutunlan, wala sang panabor, o kung anuman ang imo kahimtangan, promise ang Ginoo. Your Messiah, your God, promise that we will enjoy abundant life. Kung kumbinsido ka lang sa pagpakilala niya sa inyo. Knowing Christ is the key to life. Amen. Let us pray. Father God, thank you gid sa sininga time nga ginpahayag mo sa amon kung ano ka importante. Hindi lang nga makilala ka bilang Misaya namon, bilang manluluwas, bilang Ginoo. At ang kaimportante pagid ang pagpadayon sa pagkilala, sa pagkilala, sa pagkilala, sa pagkilala sa iyo. Hindi kami gusto, Father, nga just like sa kay Hosea masiling, nga nagaka-destroy kami, kay wala gid kami sang may nabalaan, especially kung daw ano ikaw ka nami, kung daw ano ikaw ka dako-dako, pag daw ano mo kami kapalang. And that is why, Father, kung may ari man diri nga nag-struggle subong sa ila kabuhi, kung may ari man diri nga may nagaka-overwhelm, Lord, please, reveal yourself to him. Reveal yourself to them. Show them who you are so that they will be comforted and glorify you in their life. Lord, continue to cover us with your favor. Continue to touch us and provide for our needs. Now may the love of our God the Father, the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and the power of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forever. Amen. Loving me, it's part of me.
days, thy strength shall be in measure. This the pledge to me made. Help me then in every tribulation, so to trust thy promises, O Lord, that I lose not faith with consolation. Offered me within thy holy word. Help me, Lord, when toil and trouble meeting, here to take us from my Father's hand. One by one, the days, the moments fleeting, till I reach the promised land.
Thank you.